I will test my ping when the server change kick in an NA. I'm actually quite curious to see how high my ping is. Champ actually happen if you sub right now? Well, the thing is, we need like still about 200 subs before I get new emotes. Or I get more emotes, so we need quite a lot of subs to actually get to those new emotes. But once we get there, I will make Frog Champ a thing for sure. It's too funny not to make a thing, you know? Sia is actually really good against Yasuo. It's so hard to play aggressive versus him. It's gonna be even more difficult at level. At level 6. It has to be like a constant montage of outplaying this dude. What? He still got an auto attack. But what? I think Olaf tried to dive and then it just went wrong. Double the ones against this dude. Seems pretty appropriate. Indeed, indeed. Oh! I don't think Riven had flash, so Lee could have went for that maybe. He had a better way of hitting his Q. Let's see, are we missing experience? No, we're not. Alright, there we go. So the question is, can I actually block SCS ultimate with my windfall? I would be very surprised if I could. And I didn't even check that before the game. Let's see, I'm just gonna try to basically push as much as I can because it's the best way to do it in this lane. Ouch. Who's that? MadBob2020, thank you for subscribing, man. Welcome to the Bird Nest. Appreciate the sub, man. Thank you very much. Alright, so basically, I just have to kind of jump around and try to juke him as much as I can. And then eventually, I might be able to go split push in this game, which is our main goal. Because actually, staying mid versus a seer later on in the game is gonna be quite tough to deal with. So yeah, right now we still have a part left, and he used both his parts, doesn't have any mana parts left, so maybe we can actually make him go now. So now that he is level 6, it's basically a lot harder to actually do anything against him. Nice, that was an easy dive. Because if I ever dash on him, just around this area, he can ultimate me into his own tower. So I have to be very careful of that. Right now, keeping the laning phase going as long as possible is pretty good for me. Once he gets blue, I might have a bit of trouble since I don't have any more putts, but outside of that, it's pretty good. Gragas is level 6 too, and let's see, he has barrier in mid, so I could have ultimated on Gragas E too, but this gave a bit more damage since I got my own Q knockoff off, and then could ultimate on top of that, and then it looked really weird, but it's actually more damage since I got one extra Q off. Alright, Azir is back. So we have actually really good farm, and since we got that kill, we got even further ahead in CS, which is pretty fucking awesome. So arrows played, a lot of wards and a lot of putts, because we are gonna play against the blue buff Azir soon. She's dead. Or maybe not, holy shit. I guess they messed that one up. Olaf didn't have ultimate to actually run at her. Damn, nice one. Gotta be careful with him ulting me into his own tower. That's why I'm not gonna keep dashing on him. So now we can go up, poke him with this Q hopefully, force him away from some tower. Alright, we forced him away from the minions a bit, didn't really deny him experience, but yeah. Oh, that's my Riven. I was like, oh shit, I'm about to get fucked. Warding the race is not really that effective most of the time. The reason it's not effective is because a jungler can just go smite the the race, and then he gets the oracle and will instantly just clean my ward. So, that obviously sounds pretty terrible. Alright, so right now we're actually denying Azir a shit ton just by forcing him to stay around. I'm gonna get in my base. Hopefully, I won't be stabbed. The reason I want a base now is just because I can get boots and I can upgrade to my static shiv, which is basically one of the best power spikes in this laning phase, as I will have a really good mixed damage. that attack onto the tower though. Good job, that's a really good gank from Gragas. Basically should end up in this tower dying. Just gonna take it as fast as possible. Damn, that was pretty damn good. But now he's just gonna die anyway. Because Riven is Riven. Let's see. Kinda just wanna wait now, so I can get my Sheen. Let's see, once this tower is down, we should be able to push up and die. Come on man, I don't even get credit for doing that. Using my wind wall for visions, I can nug up there, see it. That has to be one of the most... One more auto attack. Actually, maybe I don't even know if I had my Sheen proc up for the Aesir. If I didn't have my Sheen proc, then that was pretty dumb. But such a struggle. Such a damn struggle. I could have went into Mercs here too, but whatever. Oh, wait, 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 wait. Damn, if Riven was with me on that one! God damn it! How can I not go in on that four-man Naga? It gives you critical chance by 50% for 8 seconds. Then also you would have 100% or what? 100% crit from one item that costs 2.2k, is that what you're telling me? Alright, good job, let's back out now, let's not overextend too much versus Azir. Cause he will absolutely smash our faces in. That's how Azir works. Just come push butt, boys. Get a free tower, let's see what's... Wasn't that exactly what I said? Very unlucky. Oh my god. I'm gonna need a good Riven Q here. That one is down. That was so dumb. Oh well. Should have pinged more next time. They might actually all be running bot soon. I don't know why I can just push through here. And Riven just won a 1-2 all left, so. Trinity Force movement speed is quite good. So 3 in hip for 1 tower. Got 2 towers for free, one tower for free and that tower for free. 2 towers for free, I guess. For 1 mid tower. Why I keep using Q to proc my Trinity Force so I can attack the tower. They get the Sheen proc on the tower. Just do it in between auto attacks, it's very simple. Give some extra damage. Oh well, I should not be bad anymore anyway. It's way too greedy for me just to sit down here and wait. Because I suck at League of Legends. Might just have earned ourselves a free dragon since we stopped the Jinx base. Ouch. Pretty much impossible to push versus the Seer anyway. His Pogan stuff is way too good and we have very low range champions. We only really have Lucian and Kennen as ranged, so that kinda sucks. But there we go. Open up the map a little bit here. Damn. Alright, Riven got a turret. So yeah, that's one way to open up the map, I suppose. Good job, Riven. I could have ultimated on top of Riven, but I'm too confident, so I need to use it on my own nuggets. $50 right there.